The hit 90s sitcom Friends does a fantastic job of detailing the complicated love lives of the main characters for 10 seasons. Monica and Chandler have their obstacles, while Phoebe and Joey navigate the fling life. Still, the most complex relationship in Friends is that of Ross and Rachel, a will-they-won't-they romance that begins in season 1, and by the season 10 finale, is nicely wrapped up with a bow. Together, Rachel and Ross actors Jennifer Aniston and David Schwimmer made their characters' relationship incredibly believable on screen. It's hard to watch Friends and not get teary-eyed when the couple is fighting about whether or not they took a break.
I didn't think there was a relationship to jeopardize. I thought we were broken up.
We were on a break.
That, for all I knew, could last forever. That, to me, is a breakup.
When the duo sat down with the rest of the cast for Friends: The Reunion on HBO Max, some spicy details regarding the actors came out. But they actually blew the whistle on themselves. As it turns out, there's a reason the chemistry between Ross and Rachel is so believable. During the show's reunion special, Jennifer Aniston and David Schwimmer both admitted to host James Corden that they had crushes on one another in the first few seasons of Friends.
First season, I had a major crush on Jen. At some point, we were both crushing hard on each other, but it was like two ships passing because one of us was always in a relationship.
Aniston confirmed, noting,
saying one time to David, it's gonna be such a bummer if the first time you and I actually kiss is gonna be on national television.
She continued, sure enough, the first time we kissed was in that coffee shop. The actress explained that they channeled all of their adoration and love for each other into Ross and Rachel, which was clearly evident on screen. The actors didn't do much to hide their crushes from their colleagues on set, as they often snuggled on the famous coffeehouse couch and would fall asleep spooning one another. However, Schwimmer confirmed that they never became an item in their personal lives.
We never crossed that boundary, you know, we respected that.
Meanwhile, Courtney Cox and Matthew Perry admitted they knew of Aniston and Schwimmer's feelings for one another, and Matt LeBlanc joked that the idea that they never hooked up with one another didn't sound quite right to him. Jennifer Aniston and David Schwimmer's Friends co-stars weren't the only ones aware of the sparks that flew between the two early on in the show, particularly during season 1. In an interview with The Hollywood Reporter following the premiere of Friends: The Reunion, series co-creator Marta Kauffman and director/executive producer Kevin Bright confessed that nearly everyone on set was speculating about Aniston and Schwimmer's feelings for one another, as they were too obvious to ignore. Bright revealed, it was a very hot topic on the set because the electricity between them in the scenes was like, oh my god, they can't be acting that. There's gotta be something. Everybody was suspicious that something was going on. He added that the chemistry that David Schwimmer and Jennifer Aniston shared on screen when they were in character is what kicked off all the speculation. Everyone was curious to see if their relationship was going farther than that. But according to Kevin Bright, nobody saw anything. Nobody found anything. It was just rumors that were all based on how good they were as actors. Thanks to Aniston and Schwimmer's recent comments, we know that they were, in fact, crushing on one another in real life. Kauffman agreed with Bright, telling The Hollywood Reporter that it was pretty obvious something was up with Aniston and Schwimmer. She said, we didn't know for sure because we never asked either of them, but yes, we thought that perhaps might be going on. And just like Aniston and Schwimmer never crossed a boundary by bringing their personal and professional lives together, the minds behind Friends didn't let the stars' initial romantic feelings shape the storyline between Ross and Rachel, Kauffman explained. It did not wind up inspiring Ross and Rachel's storyline honestly at all. If anything, their ability to channel those feelings into Ross and Rachel just made the longing all the more relatable. Although Aniston and Schwimmer never became a couple in real life, at least Ross and Rachel finally got their happy ending by the series finale. All's well that ends well, right? Friends: The Reunion is available to stream on HBO Max now. Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more Looper videos about your favorite movies and TV shows are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.